Your hands to the Lord. Let's welcome the Holy Spirit in this place. Come on, somebody, clap your hands to Jesus. Holy Spirit, we welcome you in this place. Hallelujah. You are needed here. You are needed here. Oh, lift up your hand and clap your hands and welcome the Holy Spirit. Those of you who have been in this place, you know how we welcome the Holy Spirit. Why do you want me to wait, tell you what to do? Somebody welcome the Holy Spirit in this place. Hallelujah. Oh, somebody welcome the Holy Spirit in this place. You are welcome. You are welcome. Those of you who have just come, the most important person here is the Holy Spirit. And when he comes in, we clap our hands, we shout, we jump. That's what we do when we welcome the Holy Spirit. He's the boss here.
The boss one.
He is His Excellency here.
Your Excellency,
He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We tell Him we love you. We tell Him you adored here. Come on, somebody, welcome the Holy Spirit in this place. Somebody tell the Holy Ghost again, I need you. You are welcome here. I've been waiting for you. You're the one I'm longing for. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. You are welcome here. This is for you, Holy Spirit. This is for you. We are welcoming you here. Holy Spirit, come and fill this place. Bring your healing. With your warm embrace, clarify that keyboard, please. Lift your hands. Breath of God, breath of God, we need a touch from you. Spirit, you display. Pick it up, pick it up. Raise that saxophone, please. We need a touch from you. With the light of truth. Spirit, come fill this place.
Holy Spirit, come fill this place.
Lift your hands to Jesus and tell Him, Holy Spirit, come and fill this place. He's here. Come on, ready. raise your hands and tell him. Dear breath of God, we need a touch from you. Shine upon us with the light of truth. Your Spirit free, Holy Spirit found this place. Holy Spirit, come fill this place. Welcome the Holy Spirit in this place. You may be seated. Greet the pastor next to you. Tell him my life. Tell him my life will never be the same again. Amen.
Amen.
Do you know that from the highest office in this country to the lowest person, the Holy Spirit has touched someone in Jesus' mighty name? Why don't we give them a major hand clap in Jesus' name? The Holy Spirit touches people from every walk of life, from every class of people. You hear tremendous testimonies from the basin of Lake Victoria to every capital around the world. Someone is watching what's happening here every single day. We owe it to the Holy Spirit. And we are pleading with him not to live here until this country is free from witchcraft. Until this country stop being religious and love Jesus Christ and have a fellowship, a permanent fellowship with Jesus Christ. We are asking him not to leave until there's no disease in every home. Until people of Uganda are free from poverty and sickness and disease. Until every promise that he promised us is being granted. That's why I stand here every evening. And I said, watch at my sacrifice. That's why you come and spend a night here every evening. When I look at our men and women in uniform. When I look at all of you. When I look at your faith. Young people carrying witchcraft from their fathers, picking up the anointing of Gideon, determined to cleanse Uganda from every evil spirit from decades. How can I sit? I stand and give God the Holy Spirit and a standing ovation. When I see pastors leaving their flock like it was in the Bible by night, and they come and stand here day after day. Yes, they have churches. Yes, they have the ministries. But they sense something. Something is happening. When they come and they said in one unity, let's raise our voices. When I see Muslims boldly coming without fear, wearing their regalia and their hats, without being intimidated or being afraid of what will happen to them. And at the end of the day, they run to the altar to give their life to Jesus. I say, Holy Spirit, you are going nowhere, please. Somebody tell the Holy Ghost, please, you are not leaving here until my life is changed, until my family is changed. Okay, those of you still seated on your plastic chair, that is up to you. That is your problem. But some of us are so serious. We are not going to let him go until every Ugandan has received the dose of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We will sow our seeds. We will love on him. We will worship him. We will cry before him. We will repent. We'll ask for forgiveness. We'll plead and plead and plead and plead for our loved ones until diseases leave Uganda. Until Uganda become a no-fly zone. Oh God of glory, touch our hearts and touch our lives. Tonight we have one of the most powerful testimonies you have ever had. So stay tuned tonight. Don't fasten your seatbelt. Anytime you feel like God touching you, get up and run around if you don't run this way. Because there's no more room this way. But there you can jump and somersault. Don't jump from the balcony down here. Hallelujah. You may not land in the same peace. But we are so excited and what God is going to do tonight. When I saw the testimony yesterday of bad black, I know she's no longer bad black, but that's what the name knows. Every demon in hell is screaming, please give me a break. We are not giving you break, devil. We are not bringing you break. This is not your territory. Uganda is your no-fly zone. And soon East Africa will also drive you out. Somebody clap your hands and dance and jump for the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, viva. Bravo, Holy Ghost. Viva, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And he supplies energy after energy. Strength after strength. Joy after joy. Miracles after miracles. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lift up your hand and say, thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen and amen and amen. Amen. Before you sit down, let's give our thanksgiving offering, our evening offering, actually. Let's give our evening offering in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The baskets are in there. For those of you sitting around here, you can place it here in Jesus' name. Pastors, you're highly welcome. And every VIP here, judges, members of parliament, you're highly welcome. In Jesus' mighty name. Oh, protocol observed. And angels, you are welcome. Thank you, angels. These 7 days are days of angels. They are going to minister to you. God has sent them to you. Life is not going to be the same. In Jesus' mighty name. You are not going to go the same way you came in Jesus' name. By the way, you are going to leave here completely transformed and changed by the power of God. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We need to go quickly. And I know God will bless us. Please give your evening offering to the Lord. In Jesus' name. I'll ask Pastor David to come and join me. Tomorrow is our Jewish dinner. How many of you are coming? Okay. I said, how many of you are coming tomorrow? Okay, how many of you are not coming? How many of you don't understand what I'm talking about? I think some of you are already into glory land. Okay, we're going to have a Jewish dinner. We are having 77 lambs. It's like you have never seen anything like this. It's going to be powerful. We'll come at 6. And we will eat because lambs... No, leave her. Let's bring her sick. Because lambs, you can only eat them when they're hot. And we can't wait at midnight and when the food is cold. So you come at 6, we'll start serving at 6, and then we shall have our services, because so many people have booked already. And the place, this place has become too small. I'm so sorry. I love demons when they scream my name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen.
Amen.
They are about to scream your name. We'll never come back to your house. We'll never bother you again. In Jesus' name. God loves Uganda. I'm telling you. Oh Lord God, you love this country. And God is going to bless you. He loves this country because He loves you. Yeah, because He loves you. In Jesus' name. So, Pastor David, where is he? You're going to join me. We're going to. Man, all those are testimonies. Okay. Help me read this. These are testimonies.
Victory indeed belongs to Jesus. Praise the Lord, Pastor. I want to thank the Almighty for the miracle I received. I tried conceiving ever since June last year, but all was in vain. I took tabs as advised by the doctor and some herbal drinks. Still, they could not help me until I had given up. I started watching Channel 44 in November. And as I speak, Pastor, I'm 9 weeks pregnant. Praise be to God. This is Irene from Imperere. May God bless and continue using you, Pastor Robert. Praise God, brethren. My name is Lynette from Kawempe. Being part of the 77 dogs, God has given my lovely mom a well-paying job indeed. God has won the victory. Glory. Praise God. Pastor Robert, the Holy Spirit has already located my location, and I got a job in Western Uganda in the 77 dogs. I thank you, Pastor. I give the glory back to Jesus. Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord, church. I thank God for healing me and my sister of sickle cell disease. Joy and Caleb. Through Channel 44, I was healed from back pain on the Friday overnight, and I give God the glory. Victory belongs to Jesus, Sister Christine. Praise God. I got healed from external bleeding, maybe internal bleeding, when I was watching Channel 44, when the pastor said, touch where the problem is, of which I had suffered ever since a year ago, while taking expensive tablets. All in vain, I was completely healed by the power of God. Hello, 44. I am Dennis Prince, a partner. I'm grateful for what God is doing in these days of glory. Since 31st December 2016, the man of God prophesied to us, and now I'm beginning to experience better sales this season. Praise the Lord, and I'm partnering again with this ministry. Glory be to God, brethren. I got healed of back pain, which was paining ever since 2014. I am now fine. I bless the Lord for healing, for his healing hand while on TV. This is Sister Rachel from Entebbe.
Amen and amen. I was looking at something incredible. These are testimonies. They said, you still have more, Pastor David, to read. You're not just off the hook. Read some more. And this one. Save my energy. Praise God, Pastor. During the last 8 days of dogs, I got a job offer after 3 years of no job without an interview. And I did not influence in any way. It is a higher position than I have ever had. Good pay. It was surely Jehovah. Ha, 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 ha. Ha, 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 ha. Glory. Victory belongs to Jesus. I'm Leah. We lost items in a taxi on 23rd of December. We then prayed on Channel 44 and got them on 14th January 2017. Oh, come on. How many of you know when you lose something in taxi, it is gone? These guys prayed on Channel 44. They lost it on 23rd of December, and they got everything back on the 14th of January. What a mighty God. I'm Aisha Nachimori. I got healed on 7th January from abdominal sweating when I came to church. Praise be to God. Thanks to 77 Days of Glory and Pastor Kayanja. Okay, I'm Agre from Zana. Been sowing seed using mobile money, but God blessed me with 1.2 million. Victory belongs to Jesus.
Praise God, Pastor Robert and Jessica Kayanja. I am Mrs. Businje Joy from. I thank God for 77 dogs. I brought a young boy from the village to stay with me, and he disappeared away from home on the 17th of September 2016. After some time, I really got scared to tell the parents. I searched and searched for the boy with the police, but all was in vain, Pastor. But by the grace of God, through the 77 dogs, I prayed, and the boy came back on the 11th of January. Healthy and looking good. I'm really going to come with a boy and testify to the Lord for what he has done for me. Thank you so much. Praise God, church. I thank God for healing my headache. I've been suffering from this headache since my childhood. Through 77 days of glory, God healed me. Ha 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 ha. Nancha T from Chireka. Praise God, Pastor. I am Claire from Entebbe. I thank God that through Channel 44, I got healed from fibroids. I got a dream. Someone was pulling out the fibroids from my stomach. My periods were heavy, but after this dream, they became normal. Victory belongs to Jesus. And glory be to God. Praise God, Pastor. I am Harriet from Namasuba. I got healed from sharp pain in the breast through watching Channel 44. Glory be to God. I thank God for increasing our economy. Our economy favor at our work and has given us a good house in a good location. God is uniting our families. Glory be to God, the family of Mr. Peter.
Wonderful. Well, let's welcome, before we give you another testimony, let's welcome, I know because of time, Juliet Omutoni, wherever you are, from Kigali, Rwanda. You are highly welcome. You can wave to the people.
Juliet,
thank you so much.
Kigali, wubi akubantu.
In Jesus' name, people coming from all over the world. Bernard Kizito Nsubuga, He's come from Boston, USA. Please just stand up and wave to the people. You are highly welcome, sir. These people are traveling all over to come and be part of the revival.
Boston is in America.
Boston is in America. People are taking time to come and be part of the move of God. Do you understand what that means? Somebody's getting a ticket and somebody's asking a time off and taking leave and without pay so that he can come and tap into the anointing. That tells you God, the Holy Spirit is waking up everybody. Becton, England. You are highly welcome also from Becton, England, wherever you are. Just stand up and wave to the people. And William Kibabi Sewagaba from China. He's come from China. Yeah, just wave to the people so that we know where you are. There he is, William. We love you. People are taking time to come from their countries or from their students or whatever. They come and be part of what God is doing. Tony Okolo Emika and wife from Nigeria.
Tony Okolo Emika, Nemuchala, Bafudi, Nigeria. Kubengale singa kao.
Tony, come here.
Mami, Tony Okolo Jangu.
We bless God for this revival.
Zakatonda, ola revival.
I think we saw somebody, I don't know. We met somebody from Nigeria so far, did we? Oh, come on, give him a hand clap. 77 days of glory in Jesus' mighty name. I mean, this revival is literally touching the whole globe and the whole world. Why don't you clap your hands? I'm glad it's happening in
Uganda.
Amen. What part of Nigeria are you from?
Delta State, Nigeria.
From where?
Delta State.
That's your lovely wife. Uganda. Oh, you are Ugandan? No problem, but you are now Nigerian. We sold you to the Nigerians.
Pardon?
You are my daughter. And this is your husband. Where are my cows? So, man, so you, I don't even know what to ask you because you haven't paid me my dowry, so I need to. No, give them the microphone.
Actually, we've been planning to meet you. We met sometime last year in the Hotel Africana during the ceremony. Pastor's Award, but all in vain. I've been trying. I went back and I come back again to Uganda.
Okay.
So we've been on Channel 44.
Okay. Channel 44.
I was like, does it mean there's somebody like this in Uganda? Because what I have is not what I'm seeing. I always believe there was a program she used to watch, but they used so much Luganda. We said, I don't think I can go to any church in Uganda.
Program general.
One day she called me and said, come and watch this channel. It's Channel 45. I was like, me, I'm good at DSTV. But she said, you come to my room and watch Channel 44. So along the line, I saw the man. I've met this man in Hotel Africana. He said, yeah. I said, I love the way the man preach. I think I will go to his church one day. So we've been watching from TV, then even when I traveled back, I've been on YouTube, Facebook. If you look at the comments, sometimes I comment. So I came in just around December again. So I told her that we have to go there.
My goodness. You know, one of the most important things, Thank you so much. So go and prepare my cows, 1,000 of them, and then you come back. In Jesus' name. Listen. Somebody told me, said, if you can see what happens when we are overseas. I think she was a lady from Washington, D.C.
He
said, we walk with our phones on, even when you go to the bathroom, even when you are walking. It is literally amazing what the Holy Spirit is doing in 77 dogs. Pastor David, you got a message today.
Yes, Pastor. I got a call this afternoon. One of the people who was here in the overnight was calling for counseling. And she said on Friday night, she said, "Echinyonyi echiri ku kitabu cha Musumba Kayanja." You remember when we were in the overnight, the people said they were seeing a dove, the Holy Spirit, like a dove.
Overnight.
And this woman, she said that same picture which was on that, the same picture which was on the book of the Holy Spirit, that bird was speaking to her in a language she never understood. And so she was asking, "Pastor, what should I do? Because the bird was speaking to me."
That picture of
a
became alive and began to talk, telling this lady,
but
the language she could not detect. When she went back to sleep, before she slept, the voice told her,
"Yogera, yogera, yogera, yogera.
Speak, speak, speak.
So,
Pastor, what must I say?" The picture, the bird was speaking. The bird was speaking.
Uh-huh.
And the voice said, "You speak." So, Pastor, what must I say? I said, "Come to church. The Holy Ghost will tell you what to say."
Secondly, when Pastor was praying for the people who were barren, who were believing God for kids, at one point he said he saw like babies were coming from down. And the one of the people who was standing at the front, when he opened his eyes, he saw the babies coming down. And he says, "Pastor, this thing is for real." As Pastor was saying, he said, "I also, my eyes were open and I began to see the babies also coming down." In Jesus' name.
Somebody clap your hands to Jesus. Do you remember sometime in the 77 days of glory? There was a lady who came from United Arab Emirates. She carried her son. And her son had autism. He couldn't talk. He could not coordinate himself. Today she sent her daughter. I'm going to ask her to come up here with a message. Ever since she left, we've been praying. You can pass here.
Ita one.
Okay.
All right.
Hello. I'm sorry, I lost my voice. I'm
not saying your devotee, they are against.
Go ahead.
Hello, I'm Vanessa Williams. My mom came here with my brother. A few months ago, he was suffering from autism. But after the pastor prayed for him, he was better. Because I always took him to school every day, and he would not be concentrated all the time, but when he came back, he was more concentrated, and he was also focusing on what he was being told, and he's doing very well right now.
There is actually a testimony.
What about Julius?
There is a testimony she wrote. Do you have it in there?
Are we now?
You gave it to the pastor.
Got it.
She gave it to the pastor. I wanted to read it to you in her own writing. It's a testimony. Look inside there, or look at my desk. You can find it if it's at the desk. She wrote a testimony. Okay, it's here. This is her testimony. My name is Patricia Williams. I live in Dubai. First of all, I would like to thank Pastor Kayanja and Pastor Jessica Kayanja and the Kayanja Ministries for the work of God they are doing. Hallelujah. I came to Uganda with my son at the end of the first phase of 77 Days of Glory. I hope they can put that picture in. I think that boy walked to me or something like that when the service. If you can really, I know it's a long time ago, but try to dig it out. That Arab kid who came with a mother. I brought my son who is suffering from autism and he could not speak. I thank the Holy Spirit in this church. My son now is able to talk and speak properly. Glory! I also thank God for healing my back and continue to pray to God to completely heal my son. I want to ask the Holy Spirit to heal my daughter Isabel, who is sick, and my driver Shahid, who is suffering from TB. I would also like to pray for company that is about to close, even though it was just open in the recent years. I would also like to pray for my daughter and to finally get the Australian citizenship my husband had promised us years ago. I'm praying for a miracle that in the next school break, I will come with my entire family with a great testimony. Ha 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 ha. Glory back to Jesus. Somebody clap your hands to Jesus. So, you carried some things.
I did. I would like to ask Pastor Jessica to come up here, please.
Pastor Jessica, they have something for you. This is for me. But then time so quick you can see. My God.
Yeah.
Wow. Echange tebakira bako. Tebavude bakiteka mu black. Sicha kutunulira. Praise God. Thank you so much. Amen.
She also sent some company stuff. This is for the company that is failing. She would like you to pray for them and also give it out to people because there's a lot of things here for everyone to have.
Amen. So the company does what?
It is an oil company.
Okay.
For boats and tractors and motorbikes. Yeah.
Okay, so those are the things from the company.
Yes.
Okay.
And this is our seed. This is for Isabel and Joshua.
Okay.
This is from my mom. It is the 77 seed.
Uh-huh.
And this one is from me.
How old are you?
I'm 17.
Do you have a cold or you just, your voice has been like that?
Yeah, I have a cold.
Okay.
Yeah.
Put your hand on your chest. Thank you, Lord. Lord, bless her mightily and heal her totally in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. That's the guy.
You know, please.
That is the guy. My goodness. She came here, she had a problem with her back.
I'm going to go.
And actually, God is a good God. She literally took her baby. She flew in and she flew out. Faith like that cannot fail to create a miracle for you. Amen. So those ones, you can hand them over to the guys in the office. And
this last one,
uh-huh.
It is some witchcraft my mom told me to bring.
Okay.
So that you can burn it.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, put it over there. On that yellow thing. In Jesus' mighty name. Can you take this one for me there as well? Father, we pray for you and we break the powers of witchcraft from your mom, from everything. We just break it in Jesus' name. We just release the anointing of God upon her life. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Ooh, glory. Come on, somebody clap your hands in Jesus. Yeah, Pastor David, I think let's go through this. Have you gone through those?
No.
Things were here. Let's go through them and then I'm free to minister to the people. Okay. Okay, Pastor Kayanja Margaret, please, could you come here quickly? If you have come here quickly. Teacher Beatrice from Victorious Education Services. If you are here, Teacher Beatrice from Victorious, please come here quickly. Irene Nabanja from Pillar Cornerstone Church. If you could come here quickly, please. I'm Pastor Florence of Trinity Miracle Center in Tebe. If you could come here quickly. I am Pastor Lydia Mirembe Serugo. Come here quickly, please. Fatina Nava Yego, Julie Waibi in Minnesota, USA. Wenene Jennifer, if you're here. Sam Lugambwa of Kaboja. Sentongo Vincent of Entebbe. By the way, Aida Nanyanzi from Essex, Maryland, USA. Emmanuel Jones Kasule. These people, if you're here, please just come. Sarah Praise in Subuga. If they're not here, then I will. Vincent Chirago of Kirombe. Vincent Chirago of Chirombe. Pastor Musungu. Oh, Pastor Musungu will give two windows for the soldier's house, the house of the soldiers yesterday. Yeah. Praise, okay. So, this one is, his name is Perez. He does roofing. What is the soldier? It was yesterday. This gentleman is offering you a free, if you'll offer him transport, food, and accommodation, he will roof your church, I mean your house. He will go and roof it for you for free. Okay. Okay, that is personal. Okay. So we start where? Let's start here. What is your name? Oh, some of you came with other people. Okay.
Praise God, church. God is good. And all the time, we want to thank Pastor Kayanja and Pastor Jessica, Pastor Arthur, for the wonderful work you've done for Victorious. We came when our candidates were going to sit for primary living. We brought our list, and Pastor laid his hands on the list. But Pastor, I'm here to give a testimony. Our children performed so well. Out of 130 candidates, 113 got first grade. The rest got second grade. And the last child got 19 aggregates. Isn't that good? Wasn't it God? We really thank God because God is able. Pastor, we are here to thank you. We brought our seed of 1 million and we have already handed over. And we are requesting you to continue praying for Victorious. We want expansion. We want to get more children. Our children are very good. You've always seen our daughter's praise here. And she's wonderful. So we are asking you to bless us. One of our head teachers has a problem with sight. That is Kadago Frida. She was unable to come. But I know she's watching us. We are requesting you to pray for her. And we are requesting for peace, for success, for development, and for quality parents.
Okay, let's stretch our hands and let's pray for victorious schools. Father, we thank you. That which is born of God always overcometh the world. No weapon formed against your people shall prosper. Lord, we thank you. You protected the schools. You blessed the children. They keep on increasing every day. We glorify your name. We exalt your name. The people of God will always prosper. Bless the parents. Bless their work. Bless the school. Take it to a level of your glory. Because they honor you in that school. They lift your name in that school. They look up to you in that school. Bless them mightily. Increase them every hour. Solve all their problems. Teachers are also human beings. They need miracles. Bless the teachers. Bless the head teachers. Bless the workers there. The chefs and the cooks and the parents and the management. In Jesus' name. Victory belongs to Jesus. Amen. Amen. God richly bless you. And I know God is going to bless you more. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
God is going to bless you more. He's going to bless you more and more. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
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 Yes. Yes, Pastor.
Robert, Pastor Robert, I just stand here to testify. Thank you for being the man that you are and for Channel 44. Let me say this. I came here with a totally different mentality some time ago, wondering, you know, what is this about tithe and thanksgiving and seed? And you know, so many people are very critical of that. One day I came with an open heart. And I said to myself, let me go. And let me understand what this thing called seed is about. And I came here, and I remember when Mike Murdoch was here, we got $200 US. And we planted a seed. Pastor, it's amazing the doors God has opened for us. Right now, as we stand here, just over Christmas, my wife bought me a new car. Woo, man!
Oh, come on, somebody. Clap your hands to Jesus.
Come on, somebody.
Man, I rejoice. When no two day one see, oh, just feel like board.
Get up on your feet.
You see, I just feel the anointing. I feel the anointing.
You feel the anointing?
I feel the anointing.
I feel it with you.
You see...
May the anointing of wives starting buying cars. You know, before you continue, listen, this is very powerful. Okay? I know men, you have to buy your wife a car. I'm gonna do one. I owe this girl a good car. I owe her a good car. I don't know. Maybe a jet. Maybe a jet will be better for Pastor Jessica.
Yeah, Pastor Jessica.
Anyway. But seriously, this is, you know, usually men buy cars. But when you see wives buying cars, it seems that the Lord and the anointing and the Holy Spirit is now favoring wives to give them enough income, which is not an African trend. Come on, clap your hands for Pastor Maureen Perahanta. Yes.
Yeah. I'm still continuing. The blessing is just too much. Now, this very year, you know, I've been renting. But in 6 months, I'll have bought my own home. and I will have finished it. The power of a seed.
Come on, somebody wants a house in this place. In 6 months, he would have repaid his off.
Done. Oh
my God.
Done. I just feel the anointing. I feel. Should I go on?
Amen.
Should I go on?
Yes.
My children sat down for 1.5 years. There was no fees. We had what to eat, we had what to drink. But there was no fees. You remember the boy standing here and saying he was not in school?
Yes.
Yeah, I remember. And you planted a good seed in him.
Yes.
But as I speak right now, God has opened up finances. Everyone is going to school. Everyone.
Kati gwe tulanga babo tebanadda yo ku somero. My God.
Now, hallelujah. Now, listen, before you get so excited, Pastor, this is what God laid on our hearts when the children were at home. He said this as we prayed and said, our children are sitting home, there is nothing. He said this, find someone who needs to go to school and pay their fees. So we picked on a girl in the choir who had stopped at S6, and we paid the fees very painfully. Suddenly God opened the door so wide. Am I talking to somebody here? You see, Pastor, the Lord showed me one thing about seed. You don't plant a seed from your surplus. You plant a seed from your need. It is when you need that you plant seed. Now look at this. The widow in Zarephath had nothing at all but a little food for her son and herself to eat and die. God did not say, leave those alone, they are poor. He said, give it to the man of God. Because after that you are going to be fed all your days until God sends the rain on the earth. And it was done. So seed is planted where there is a need. If you just give because you have, you are just disposing of what you don't need. Give out what you need so that you get what you can. God will give you. Only God can give you. And so, Pastor, we have been doing ministry and we are in Nambole Church. Nambole Stadium. Very prophetic. We are in that place. We've been there for 7 years. Been struggling. Bit with rent and machines are a problem. Our machines are quite old. We look here and we say, wow, this is amazing. You know, this is good. We need media machines. We need all these things. But you know, that doesn't stop the anointing of God flowing. God is starting to do a new thing within Real Life Church. Starting to do a new thing. Recently, there is a gentleman who came and he planted his seed of 1,000 Kenyan shillings. He said that's all he needed. His house was still down. he was wondering if the rains come, they're going to destroy it. He planted that seed of 1,000 Kenyan shillings. No sooner had he planted that seed within the ministry, he was asked, how much money does he need for that house? He said he wanted 950. Immediately, God gave him 1,000,000 shillings right there. That same anointing that is on you, Pastor, that is flowing right now all over the world in different places, is the same anointing we need on our hearts, in our ministry. And right now, out of our learning that you have impacted us, we also want to plant a seed. One is going to go to you and Jessica. We are planting 1,000,000 shillings. Pastor, go and eat and grow fat and prophesy. Hallelujah. Give the man a God. Hey, you know, we've never planted 1,000,000 shillings, but the anointing is upon us now. Now, from real life church right now, Nambole, those 400 people that we passed right there, been praying. God bless that ministry. Give us equipment. Maybe give us a radio station and a TV station and equipment. And we want to get out of that stadium also and have our own land. Get out of rent. We are going to plant another seed from Real Life Church. 1,000,000 shillings. God bless you so much, Pastor.
Well, Pastor, the Lord is expanding the kingdom. And one of the things God is doing is breaking the spirit of religion. Which sits on the gifts of God. Now, I'm going to say something. I wasn't going to say it, but let me say it. The English language is God anointed. Okay? I always tell people, like John Evanzini, he said country music is backslidden gospel.
Yeah, gospel.
You see, they sing things. They sing about real life. But they leave you hanging. Religion, you look at the word religion.
Dini.
It is R-E-L-I-O-N. Religion, or R-I-G-I-O-N. When Jesus asked the man who was mad,
yes, we have used a message.
He asked, "Who are you?" And the demons say, "We are a legion."
But we tell legion.
Now the man had 1,000 demons. I know you're gonna hate me for this.
Yes.
But the truth will set you free. The truth will set you free. The man said, I'm a legion. Now in the Roman, a legion means 1,000. That's how we know the man had 1,000 demons. But there were demons anyway. Now when you
the legion. When you read the legion, I hope somebody is hearing what we are talking about. So that's why religion is already bound, whether you like it or not. It's dangerous. The man was cutting himself with stones. And you know why Jesus sent the demons into the pig? Demons into the pigs? Because the area is known as Gennesaret, or the land of the Gadarenes. Now, the Gadarenes, the word comes from the word Gad. G-A-D, Gadarenes. These are the members of the tribe of Gad. And as Israelis, they had no business raising pigs. So Jesus saw these demons.
Yes,
and the demons sent us in those pigs. And Jesus said, go ahead, I don't eat pork, I'm Jewish. Now, God bless you. Those of you are eating pork, God bless you. I'm not saying there are demons in pork. No. Pork is eaten in my family.
Yeah.
I just don't eat it. But members of my family enjoy it, and I bless it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
There's no problem with pork. Whatever is wrong, we bless it. Even snakes. If a snake was come here and the devil is in it, I'll cast the demon out of the snake. And I'm hungry, and I'll eat the snake. Oh, you didn't hear, right? Just okay, greater is he that is in you than the devil in the world. Apostle Paul teaches us that do not be caught up in this religious war. Don't eat, don't do this, all this food is wrong. No. We've been set free. Brother, enjoy your pork. Eat your snake. Or your monkey, or your rat, whatever. Once you bless it in the name of the Lord. But Pastor Chigozi, it's the spirit of religion. It doesn't only tie you, it ties the people around you. Do you know that when Jesus cast those demons into the pit, the community sat and drove Jesus out? They, one of their own was bound, was walking naked, is free. But they said, no, get out of our region. But the demons never left the region, because the Bible said, are you listening to what I'm talking about? I hope somebody is listening to what I'm saying. That's the dangerous danger of religion. You have to, religion is equal witchcraft. Let me say it again. I know you are very religious people. But religion is as equal as witchcraft. Let me tell you. They kicked Jesus out of their region.
Yes,
because they kept their religion. Religion always kicks Jesus out. But the demons did not leave their region. Because the Bible said they entered into the pigs, and the pigs went into their water. So they waited for them when they came to get the water. They kicked Jesus out,
yes,
but the demons were never kicked out. They came out of the man, and the man said, please let me follow you. I'm going with you. Jesus said, no, go. You go tell your family. He said, I want to go with you. Why was the man saying, I want to go with Jesus? A stranger. Because he realized if he stays around here, he's going to be stuck in the same situation.
True.
Now, we are buying equipment because the sound we have, the crusade equipment, is not enough. And we need tens of thousands.
Yes.
Okay? Tens of thousands of dollars.
Is that dollar?
But while I was standing there, before you even said, I'm planting a seed in you, the Lord said to my heart, and me and my wife, if God tells her, we go with it. The Lord told me that tomorrow we are planting a seed of $5,000 into your ministry. Yeah, go buy those whatever you have to buy.
Wow.
When God opens the door, He opens the door. Really? Okay, you're all looking at me like. I mean, if we are buying equipment worth $150,000, and what we have in the account is $5,000, it's a seed. We sow a seed out of our need. So why do we hold on to that when you can plant it somewhere and it can do some good? You know, people of God, you said something that is powerful, Pastor. You sow out of your need. But you can't, if you give out of surplus, you are discarding. You're discarding. So tomorrow we're going to get that 5,000. Yeah. I don't know what it can buy, but buy something. Let God do something incredible. Man, we are blessed. We receive the seed in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Amen. I wanted to share something that happened to me when I was pregnant. I don't know if it has happened to other women, but our babies are a gift to us. Some of you don't know that Maxwell is our adopted son, and Melissa, who's at home right now. 12 years we were in our marriage without a child, and God blessed us with Melissa. Earlier, we adopted Melissa and then Maxwell, and then Maxwell and Melissa used to lay hands on our stomach and pray for a baby. Can you imagine? Yes. And then I got pregnant. That was the miracle baby that came, Melody. Melody's at home. She's a lovely, beautiful girl. But in my pregnancy, I remember this came to me live in my bed. A very big giant with a goat head, dripping nails, came to my womb wanting to pluck the child out of my womb. And I remember I arose with all the might inside of me, and I prayed in the spirit, and that being left. But recently my daughter described saying the same thing, and I wondered what that was about. She said, "Mommy, I dreamt this thing with dripping nails coming after me." So I thought I'd share that. But I know that the enemy has his thing against our children, as you know, as pastors. But I know we serve a God who's victorious. Amen? Amen.
Yeah, you know, that's why we are getting these young people filled with the Holy Spirit. Because what happens, what your daughter was seeing, is that the same spirit that was hindering you from getting pregnant was coming to attack her. That when the time comes for her to get married, she will struggle as you have struggled. So how do you overcome that spirit? And it may have come from your aunties and from generations, but you broke it. You broke it. Now your daughter has to break it. But you have to combine mother and daughter. That's why I like the Saturday prayer clinic. And because it's a mother-daughter thing. You wage war. You wage war. You fight and break that spirit. Whether the devil likes it or not. My God, hallelujah. Our children are going to get an idea about the devil before he comes. Our children are going to dream dreams before he ever attacks them. They are becoming spiritual
spiritually astute, aware of what is going on, and they will not allow the devil to ever bother us again. Somebody clap your hands to Jesus. Well, Pastor, man, I love you. I pray that God will increase your ministry in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Fine. So I want to thank God for last year. I was praying to God that I will get a sponsor in drumming. I drum. So this, on January, someone has booked me up to drum for them in a youth meeting. And Pastor, I've been struggling with some spirits which are disobedient spirits.
Yeah, they will never come back again because you are a man of God now. Amen. Somebody clap your hands. I love when kids know and they can identify the powers of darkness. Come on, somebody clap your hands to Jesus. My God. Men, after coming out of Friday and yesterday with the crowds which were there, I am kind of concerned because we need sound bad. And I was looking at the accounts today of sound, and I said, but after I've given that seed, now I know sound is coming. Child of God, there are two ways to look at what you have, at what is coming. But what is coming is better than what you are looking at. Wow.
Hallelujah.
I love this. Thank you, Pastor. Yes.
Hallelujah. Mukama yebazibwa abooluganda.
Praise the Lord.
Obujulizi bungi naye nja kutekuwaako obutono. Ekisooka nebaza Mukama.
I thank God.
Before 77 wano namuyingiriramu wakati.
I came in the middle of 77
fast first.
Before I came in,
omulabe yali alumbye amaka gange.
Satan had attacked my home. There was no joy in the house.
Puny
little things would cause us strife. Nobody was smiling at the other.
But one time, ntambuza TV nengwa ku channel 44.
As I was scrolling and I came across channel 44 one time.
Actually, ngendo jigwa akonga mpulira obulokole buntamye nga ngambo bantandika okunywa ku mwenge.
At that time, I was getting fed up of salvation. I wanted to start drinking.
But God is so good.
Mukama mulungi.
Eyo week je nayingirira mu 77 musumba yali ali nnyo ku nsonga y'omwenge.
The week I came in, Pastor was always talking about wine and intoxication.
You people, I was so blessed.
Mukama nampa omukisa.
I glorified God.
Nengulumiza Katonda.
Nasoke emirundi egyasooka, I used not to come here because my husband would not allow me because we have a baby.
Sajjanga mwami nga tanzikiriza kuba tulina omwana omuto.
Naye nga nsula ku TV ne nkabiira Mukama ne mugamba Mukama weebale ontaasizza.
I watch all night long.
Mbadde simanyi kintu kye ŋŋenda kuyingiramu.
I did not know what I was going to get into.
Then obujulizi obulala.
The second testimony.
Nebaza Mukama.
I thank God.
Olw'obujulizi abantu bwe bawa bano buzzaamu
abantu. Testimonies people give, they are such an encouragement to all of us.
Way back, nali ŋŋamba naye lwaki abasumba boonoona obudde nga bagamba abantu bawe
obujulizi omugaso gw'obujulizi.
Few weeks back,
week into nezise,
not even a week, it has been a period of time, nali nagwamu amaanyi nga mpulira sikyayagala kuwaayo
nga mpulira
bintamye.
I was fed up of giving.
Naye waliwo omuvubuka yajja wano musumba gw'owe motoke yagamba nti yali agamba nze mpabuwi Katonda Katonda yetampa.
There is a pastor who came and said, for me, I think my lot is just to give, never to receive.
I was going through the same situation.
Nange nga mpita mbeera yemu.
Nga mpulira mpaayo nnyo.
I was feeling I was always giving.
Buli isho ejja mu church ne bagamba nti kati tuweeyo ku kino nga mpaayo nga bwe nsobola.
I was always giving.
Actually, before that guy came,
I just won
$1 million
and I brought it here.
As a seed.
But I wanted to go to driving school with the same money.
Said,
God, you've taken this one as well?
So I had some $200 I was supposed to pay for rent. Katinga landlord yangamba amanja $500 yet in actual sense is amanja $200.
The landlord thought I was supposed to pay $500 instead of
$200. So I was on TV musumba no yogera kunsonga yebyuma.
While watching TV you talked about equipment.
Nengamba kati mu kifo ky'okusasula sente zino eri omuntu atakkiriza nti sente za manja sizezo. Let me bring it to church.
I decided to turn that rent money into a seed.
You people, I brought that man and I got peace.
Nenfune mirembe.
Kati lero musumba.
Today,
some weeks back, we were talking about kogera ku nsonga ya Jewish dinner.
When you started talking about the Jewish dinner,
Ningamba Mukama would have been part of this.
God, I must be Kuhanga part of this.
Banga, it was even my first time to hear about
I've never
it.
Witnessed this or heard about it.
So Ningamba Mukama singo mpo mukisa.
I said, should God
I'll
bless
be a part of this. Katimba and Yahweh, I felt something upon my heart that I should bring 7 sheep.
Mpuli denga neta kukulete ndiga msambu.
Praise God. So when it came upon me, Nengamba, na imu kama angezo sente, sizilina right
God,
now.
I don't have that kind of money right now.
Atenga, I knew today was my deadline.
And this was a deadline.
So yesterday,
Joe,
ninagwe nalimanja, nebampa sente, choka sente, zebampa denga, zima labu maziku gulandi, gamusambu, ne transport wazo.
Somebody who had my money paid me, and the money was the exact money to buy the 7 sheep and to transport them.
At exactly when I was here and I brought them.
Samu samu na lese ndiga.
Katine ngamba zine ndiga, nemba gamba, ndiga mwemba tuma.
I said, I'm sending you sheep.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
By the way, nsige yogeda.
You know, seeds speak.
Yes, olava tuleta sente nezogeda, but what about sheep?
Mine speaks,
sound.
But a living sheep speaks also.
Mukama yeba zibwe.
Praise the Lord.
So nengamba buli ndiga nganji, what den songa rache agenda. There were 7 and I had 7 issues.
I was assigning all the 7 sheep with different assignments.
Praise Jesus. Endige ya sose na jigambie ndiga gwen kusindika eri aba yimbibo nabali balokoka ne babivako as they slaughter you there ngokuba omulanga ko olaba abayimbibo nabali baba mu bulokozi bakomewo mu bulokozi.
The first ship's assignment is to call back all the backslidden musicians, all the gospel artists that fail, come back to God.
Endige yo kubiri ne njigamba.
The second assignment.
No more Islam, no more polygamy in Uganda.
Techali busilam, techali kuwasa bakazi banji mu Uganda.
Fire!
Actually, Pastor, my location, in my location there is a mosque.
Wembera waliwo msikiti.
My location where God has directed me, the
where
location
God
you were talking about. Kati! When Namazo Gambendi gay, Yoku Vidinti, no more Islamic in Uganda, no more polygamy.
When I send that
Nengenda. I bought these things. Actually, I came here yesterday. Yesterday was Sunday. Nengula magazines, ikumi.
I bought 10 magazines. I said, I'm going to go to the city where they sell these things. I give them a magazine of the Holy Spirit
as a sign that we are closing up this business in
the business
Uganda.
The business. No one is going to buy them. Nobody's going to do that business no more.
Everyone should come to God.
Bring them to a local cake. Praise the Lord.
The biggest pain we have in families is polygamy.
Most problems
are because of polygamy.
Even
but if this comes to an end, Uganda will be fine.
Uganda jakuwa bulungi.
Mukama yebaze.
Praise the Lord.
Actually, musumba nze sikirizaganya na kintu kye bagamba.
I don't believe in what they say.
Abakazi bato banji nya basajja batono.
That there are more women than men. So a man should have more.
I believe God created each woman for one man and one man.
Katonda buli mchala nga mukoledde omusajja uwe era buli musajja no mukazi gwaino kuwaso omu.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord. I told the third
ship,
I'm tired of raining.
You
want to leave at 6 a.m.
because someone gave you a lift you have to go.
And when they're leaving, you have to go with them. I'm fed up.
I told the ship,
when they are cutting you,
I'm receiving my vehicle. This time round,
that I used to buy, I said this time round, when they give me that money, I'm going to prestige.
Before 77 comes to
what
an
is prestige?
Age,
what is prestige
driving school?
Oh, okay, okay.
Nagamba mukama before 77 comes to an end, I have to drive.
Nino kufuge motoka.
Atera sinagwa mumanyi. Still God will provide, I have to drive.
Nino kufuga.
Before 77 comes to an end.
Nisamu samte nagwa. Nino kufuga.
It's a lot, but I know God is answering all those
mukama
prayers. God bless you.
Mukama bwa mukisa.
Kati zonenda enda. Anyway, the revelation.
You've given me a rema word, revelation.
Because out of our farm, I also brought those lambs.
I've completed them.
Put that picture, please.
Tell which one.
Those beautiful lambs you've seen.
I brought them from our farm.
For you tomorrow. I brought
them.
Those are hybrid.
Is it hybrid?
You say, why do you offer such a thing? Because I'm believing God for many things. Also mine. The picture is not enough. They are mine as 1911 is how much?
30.
30. I'm giving for tomorrow.
Those
are the ones.
I don't know where you. I'm sending them to speak.
Mwana gwompa the revelation.
You've given me a revelation.
Namwe baba sale cha.
When they are carrying
you, ugenda kuogera biriga mwe.
You are going to speak. My God.
Nina list.
I have a list.
Somebody clap your hands to Jesus.
Man,
we're going to have a great time. You see, God is good.
Comfort is leaving Uganda.
You on my behalf. So you haven't learned how to drive the car yet.
Not yet.
You haven't gone there.
Not yet.
How much is driving school?
Santa Mekeza driving school.
Where I went, they told me 610.
610.
Yeah.
How much did you pay for those?
740.
740.
So it's 100 and how much is each?
Each was sold to me at 100, then 40 was for transport.
Those mines are hybrid. I sell them 400, 500. Yeah, those are the best you can get. Oh, those are the one you brought, right?
You know what I say?
Okay. Sister Jessica. Million AM.
She go to driving school.
Let us sheep speak. You sheep, I'm sending you.
Clap your hands to Jesus. My God, my God. My God, my God.
Pastor, I have some small prayer request here. Besides the physical things that I need from God, I'm asking God to help me to learn how to. I've been forgetting a lot. You can tell me something right now, and by the time I move outside, they have forgotten. So I pray to God that I stop forgetting like that. Then, another thing I pray that God may help my spiritual life to grow. I've been living a time where my reading the Bible has gone down, my praying has gone down. I've taken years without fasting. Actually, it is 77 that I started coming to overnights again.
How many of you feel before 77 days you are where she is? Jesus Christ. But now you feel your love for God has gone to another level. You're not alone. We all needed the Holy Spirit. He has dealt with me this 77. Oh my goodness, the Lord has dealt with me. I'm not yet there. I know I'm going to be there. I pray that before 77 is over, then I'll be there 100%. Do you understand what I'm saying? I want to be there. Because I know I can be more sensitive to the Holy Spirit than I am now.
When you're
77,
here in 77,
to swallow,
we are not embarrassed.
We ask what we want, what we need.
You
remember we talk about cleansing today.
If you need to be washed, don't get scared. Don't fear what people will say. Let the righteous continue.
We want God
in our
marriages, in our homes, with our children, with our ministries. Do you understand what I'm saying? We want things that are genuine. Things that are fake don't last. And they
are heavy.
I love what sister said.
She nearly went back to drinking alcohol.
But now she's on fire.
She's now sending sheep on mission.
Are you having fun today? This is another method of giving testimonies. We've never given testimony like this before. But this is the leading of the Holy Spirit. I'm just excited. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Okay, we have to hurry up. Okay, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Yes. The sheep will speak.
Let
the sheep speak.
Praise the Lord, church.
Amen.
I have a sister in the U.S., Minnesota. She requested me to bring her a seed for the PS system. And she has a prayer request also. She wants God to bless her womb with children. God bless you.
Touch your womb. You're standing in proxy of her. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. Lord, her left ovary has problems. But Jesus, as we stand here today, you recreate that ovary. Touch, Holy Spirit, I give you praise. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mukama omulungi yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Nebaza Katonda olw'omukisa guno gwampadde.
Thank God for this opportunity.
I used to be a Muslim. God had mercy on me and saved me.
Pastor, buli jonda ba family zinga zija no ziwo obujuli zinga ngamba nayitawa.
I've been seeing families coming to testify.
Na yitawa kutuka katuti.
I didn't know how I would be able to get here.
Nina auntie wange abadde asimbala ino kwa obujuli nti yawona omugongo.
My aunt has been lining up to testify.
Nebuli bwabanga abuzaye abantu batano ngagamba ah tukomawa.
Many times she's not able to come.
Na yenga nze munda munze ngamba mpakuza ntia.
I was wondering how to be able to
Nene baza
thank God for this opportunity. God sent somebody. Since you've sent me, I'll talk about your stuff and talk
hallelujah
about my stuff. Praise the Lord.
From Boston.
There's a family from Boston.
Yeah, Pastor Apple Kato, Judith Kwagala.
Oh, Pastor Kato and his wife. They're watching me right now.
They're
given 770,000
seed.
The husband and wife are praying. You pray for one of their sons.
Well,
he's so committed to the church work, but he's not
balancing.
He loses stuff.
Martin Jangut over to church and Baku Baku Togana Fugresa Wangatan.
His life is not balanced. He's always so overly committed to church work and he's not committed to other things. The parents want him to serve God. But he also needs to take care of his other life. You don't just be irresponsible with other things. Don't just leave clothes untaken care of. They're asking for a better job that has no sorrow. They're asking also they want another kid. That's the family of the Katos. And this is his seed.
Hallelujah. Waluo omchala amuita Sarah Chamba the Walker.
She's Sarah Chamba the Walker.
Naya Vudam Boston and Tumyo from Boston.
She's also from Boston.
Alesen Sigoya Yemitualon Samfumo Musam.
She's also sending a 770,000 seed.
Pastor Kwagalanyo.
She loves you so much.
Naye asaba bino. Emanga. Muwala we yava tachanywe. Sija gamati yava mubuloko la yagala yesu. Naye singa boyali. Gatana wagenda bweru. Echo kubiri. Yalekera okusoma nenga omuzadde ayagala omuwala wadde mwasome.
The daughter has weakened enough faith and also wants the kid to go back to school.
Aina n'omwana omulala amuita Hilaria.
She has another child called that.
Naye yenyikidde nnyo mu church ekirungi. Yenyikidde mu church. Naye ebyokusoma byetabi balancinga.
The kid is also not balanced. He overly commits himself to church.
Asaba omusabire mu linnya lya Yesu.
Not doing other things, so pray for them as well.
Waliwo ensiko ono bamwita Mukisa Masi.
This is Mukisa Masi.
Awadde ensiko ya pound 3.
3 pound seed.
Naye asaba ebintu bino musumba.
Asking these things. That person wants to know God. Wants to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Wants to fear God. Wants to go to America. They are pursuing the papers to help him go. Wants to know the purpose why they are on earth. Why did that person come on the earth? That may God bless the parents and asking for wisdom as well. He wants to succeed in primary 7 this year. These are the things that the people sent me to tell you.
But
me as an individual, I have a tangible spirit of poverty on my life. When I get money,
That's when people who needed to show up. Someone may say, I want 300,000. You've got 500. And they plead. You take off the tithe. You give them the 300. At the end of the day, they ain't got nothing to save. I'm not saying giving is bad. Something is not connecting. When I ain't got no money, nobody asks me nothing. But once I get money, everybody begins to call.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Pastor, the family where I'm born, they told us that our parents switched our blessing, that they were rich and they made the kids get married to devils, that whoever gets a man, you dream cows chasing you. You dream all men saying you can't go
father.
We don't want money from the clan. We want the blessing of the Lord. That will bless the work of your hands. That's what you're crying about.
You are right. Now,
kakati.
I know they are watching us. Let me directly speak to those parents whose children, their heart is driven in the things of God. You're living in a very troubled nation called the United States. Actually, it will be a privilege and grateful for you that your children love God now with all their heart and they want to serve God. In my family, we believe in education. We educate our children. We even educate the children who are not ours. We send them to school. We push them so that they can succeed. But there are two things you have to understand. That when we are starting in ministry, we make vows, especially Pastor Kato. While I was there, the Lord told me, he made a vow that if God will take me to America, if God would, whatever I have in my hand, whatever I get, I'll give to the Lord like Gideon. Gideon vowed to the Lord, Pastor, you vow to God to give him your first fruit. And your first fruit is your son. You made that vow. Now what you have to do, you are living in a world that everything around you, like she's talking about her parents, that her parents dedicated them to demons, that they dream these cows, that they dream these old people, claiming them. So when we dedicate our children to serve God, what we have to do is to put God first in them and put education around them, not the other way around. That's why God always said, the firstborn is mine. Now you are privileged. So now decide, what are you going to do? Yes, your child needs discipline. He needs to understand. All parents do that. We spoil our firstborn and we destroy our lastborn. I said we spoil our firstborn and we destroy our lastborn. But hear the Spirit of the Lord. Whatever you put in the hand of God, it will never get spoiled. Whatever you put in the hand of God, Jesus said, whoever you gave me, I have lost none but the son of perdition. So God, whatever you give God, whatever you give God, so raise your children.
There's education in the United States. There's no kind of, please, listen.
Is anybody here charging your phone or something? Never do that on the pulpit. I know there are sockets around you, and never
charge
your electricity, your electrical system. Okay, the Holy Spirit will say,
that now put education around your son and around your daughter. Let them serve the Lord. Make sure they are not hiding in the church to do something evil. Because they have a zeal of doing that thing. Now, if they get out of church and they start doing drugs, they will do drugs and nobody will be able to pull them out. They will drink and nobody will pull them out. So, put education around them. You're in a country of opportunity. They can do homeschooling. They can do evening classes. They can do, put things around them that will cause them to love the Lord. Because children who you give to the Lord, we make vows when we are in tough times.
Please.
I give
you everything.
I give
you my kids.
I
give him my life.
That day,
you thought he forgot. You thought he forgot.
Kati
when he comes and texts his own, you start murmuring and complaining.
So the key is, be grateful that your children love the Lord. But now, do the parent work. That which God cannot do for you. Bring education around them. Let them take short courses. Make sure they hang around good people. Find other friends that can be a challenge to them. Parents is never easy. That's what we are learning. We have teenage kids. And there's no manual for parenting. Either for the church, and we people in the church, we do a very bad job. Because either we neglect our children, not knowing that they are the prophets for tomorrow. And secondly, you must also understand this, Pastor Kato and all of us. There are people in your church that look at your child as a miniature pastor. So everything they speak to them, you're
going
to be a pastor.
You're the one who is
going to die.
As though your dad is going to die tomorrow.
Every person has his own life and his own calling. And education is very important to anybody. Be a soldier, be a teacher, be somebody. But put God around your children. Put education around your children and give them God. Encourage them in the things of God. And then from there, they will begin to understand the purpose of education. Because you don't stop reading. Never stop studying.
You find that
the
what they are seeing in their kid is what is in them. They also neglected other things because of their love for God.
So, like father,
like son,
like son. So, what do you do? Discipline.
We mugunjule.
Work.
Kolanyo.
Encourage. Strengthen.
Muzemuama.
Believe God.
Okirizane katonda.
Great things will happen. In Jesus' name. For you.
Katigwe.
Mukama katonda wamani. Sister.
My sister.
Bible gama nane nyomuli kululuo.
I will rebuke the devourer for your sake.
Waliwo chebayita.
There's what they call.
Olumanyi. Muluganda.
And a spirit of knowing.
Olumanyi. Nolumanyiro.
Familiar spirits.
Kateriya abantu abalino olumanyi.
The people who have a knowing. They can know when you have got
there was
a guy called Ziyevege. He had
a, his real name was Lubega.
His name was Lubega. Every time we cook beans, osho, old jobio, the guy never showed up.
This guy
never showed up. Every time they prepare chicken, Ziyebege would show up. And it's a home of reverend. You cannot refuse someone to share your meal. Because
so
one of us was going to miss their part. Because we are about 13 people.
You
cut 13 pieces.
Mama
never
eat, women
never eat chicken.
She didn't like the chicken. But
the man would show up.
Or a couple two people
would have to share a piece so the guest should eat your piece. But one day,
that's
it, kill that cock. Why are we killing it?
Ziyebege
is going to show up. So they killed it. When they killed it,
come on, balance out things.
When they killed that chicken, that cow, you roasted, cook it.
God, I don't know whether it was my brother John or somebody else.
Just about the time when they were serving food.
Guess who came?
The account.
But one of my brothers, I don't know whether it was John or David or Sam or whatever it was, he screamed, Mama!
There comes Ziyebege again.
And the man said, who is Ziyebege? Of course, Ziyebege was a family nickname, you know.
It was his nickname.
But the cat got out of the bag.
Nabigwam.
Kakati ntujule mmere.
So he served the food.
Okwati mama italia nkoko.
Because mom never used to eat chicken.
Yafumba ngevinyeba muluwombo.
She prepared the
peanut. Nafumba vijanjaro. Nasako other vegetables. Kakati tata na mugamba nti oyo mumwe vijanjaro.
Give that Ziyebege man beans. Everybody got chicken except Ziyebege. What's wrong with your mom? I've not gotten chicken. Today, we did not plan for you. Every time
no
we kill a chicken, you show up. Eat the beans, sir. And my daddy had a voice. Ziyebege never ever came back home.
What I'm trying to say is this. Yes, we must give. Yes, we must help. But we also need to use common sense.
Those demons, they bring the people. They sent them to impoverish you. Someone cries.
First of all, you are not their source. When
they come with a problem, tell them, kneel down.
In
the name of Jesus, I lay my hands on you. By the time you leave, you
will
meet somebody who will bless you. Here is transport.
2,000.
That spirit of knowing follows them.
But it is the spirit of the locust in the book of Malachi. It is the spirit of the cankerworm.
Akachaka.
It grazes and after it feeds here, it jumps here. It's the spirit of locusts. And the Bible said our tithe should resist it.
We are not the source of the people. God is their source. It's the spirit of begging. It sucks life and joy out of you. It is a high level of divination. It is high level of witchcraft. It operates in the world and in the church. Someone can sit there and pray, Father, I pray. When I go to Sister
So-and-so,
I'm a saint.
Give me money. God says,
I cannot take from Peter to give to Paul. I will give you your words. But because somebody has spoken in the spiritual realm, demon spirits grab it and they bring it down to pull you down. Lift up your hand, everybody. Turn to the person next to you. Tell him, I love you, but I'm not your source. Said again, said, I love you, but I'm not your source. Jehovah is your source. So he will give you the resource. Amen. This week, God is going to send us 7 people who are going to change our lives. So you have to understand that. And most of the people have that spirit because they are not tithers. You know, Malachi 3. Turn to Malachi 3. Let me do a teaching on this because it will be a blessing to all of you. How many of you suffer from this spirit? Wakafuna sente.
The kid falls sick.
You must understand that the coffin makers, they also are praying for the success of their business. The undertakers, the funeral services,
a plus.
See, when they place the business to succeed,
businesses,
and you know how their business will succeed.
Businesses are zita muzitia, ngavantu bafude.
You are very quiet. You are not looking at them. So you have to drive that spirit out of your house. No one is dying in my family. No one is getting sick in my family. You are the devourer. You are the devourer. Get out of my family. For he comes to steal, kill, and destroy. It's a spirit of war. You see, you can have that. That's why you rather pray for peace than conflict, than war. Because where war is, people die. That's why you pray for peace in Uganda. Because I've never seen a war where people don't die, where properties are not destroyed, where progress is not hampered, where people don't go into exile. So, child of God, that's why the Bible said, you are cast with a curse, the whole nation. Now, because this spirit called familiar, we call it in the Bible, similitudes. The spirit of the similitudes. As soon as you get your money, before you even plan for it,
just come to say hi. What's happening in the village?
No, from today, angels are coming to you in Jesus' name. Abraham overcame that spirit when he let Lot go. He never wanted Lot to go, but he let him go.
because that spirit was costing him a lot. There was no problem between him and Abraham. I want to see the spirit of similitudes. Oh. I want to see the spirit of this Rumani Roro. Eh?
That familiarity follows you everywhere.
Eh? Rumanyango finyane sente.
Knows whenever you get money.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? Many of you are losing it today. Other people carrying it without knowing they are carrying it. That spirit makes you a beggar. Even you who receive the money, you do nothing out of the money. It makes you lazy. You just go to this sister, it gives you something. It gives you a clothes, and you keep on walking. And you keep on rotating. And it's a spirit that strikes you after you got saved, or you surrender to the devil. So you become an agent of destruction instead of development. You become an agent. It's kind of it twists you around so that you lose purpose. So that you're expecting, I must be given always. I must receive.
No,
what tells you that you have to receive? Why don't you become a giver? It's more blessed to give than to receive. The moment you get that in your concept, you are not an agent of begging. You are not an agent of the devil. You are not an agent of witchcraft. That spirit,
do you know that?
Is so funny.
Sit
down, everybody. How many of you, when you are growing up and you had the older sisters or brothers, an idea came to you out of nowhere? Out of nowhere. Or when you are going to meet somebody, or the president, or anybody, or your big boss, that something came to you and told you, don't dress your best, dress your worst. How many of you had that thing talk to you? Stand up.
Something will tell you. You're going to see somebody. But don't dress nice. Don't dress neat.
Yamba na faji faji bono tuke yo basolo kwa
but they feel pity on you abantu
bafunye kirowoze echo.
You ever got that idea? Get up.
Obaba ali bachikoze eko.
Or you've ever done it?
Ngo ina wogenda.
You're going to see somebody.
No tajia yongozo singa.
You don't dress your best.
No malaga mbala buo.
You just wear
no wogenda. Muimirire.
Get up.
Ndagala kuba revelation.
I want to give you a revelation.
The power and the anointing you have inside of you.
Futa go ina mbulambo.
Kati spirit yeyo.
That spirit
is a spirit of destruction. It's what turns you into a beggar.
Tells you don't wear good. They will think you're okay, so they won't give you any money.
That spirit, because I had the elder sisters and brothers and the will to do.
Medicine, others in hotel business, others were lawyers. I had some decent shoes, some nice shoes. When I come from a soul, the spirit will tell me, don't wear good. Because they go to see, they leave the nice shirt. And they put on their worst. They're looking like they're about to die tomorrow. They look like they blow the pipe. One time,
I was invited to preach at John Austin. I met my spiritual father in 1985. In January, February here. He invited me to go to US. I was with him in the house. The man took me and dressed me in double breast suits. He bought three. With shoes and ties. He said, when you go to America, he said, you either wear African garments or you wear these suits. Double breast. Be a gentleman. Don't be a beggar. Now they took me to John Austin, the father of Joel Austin. And he said, you are preaching Sunday night.
Sunday.
And
I'd gone with my clothes. They were not at that level, though they were not that bad.
I was in a hotel. They're about to pick me up. I have got three double breasts.
Speech ngamba. That spirit told me. If you are the ones that T.L. was bought for you, nobody's going to give you a dime. Wear the miserable looking clothes. Oh my God, tear the shoe.
That spirit is very destructive. It's manipulative and controlling. And I'm glad you shared this because I wasn't going to share this.
But it's going to be okay.
So I dressed up.
Nenyambala.
And the phone rang.
Esimunevuga.
Your ride has come.
Bakuchimye.
I'm going to the door.
Nalingena kuluchi.
I opened the door and it could not open.
Olujenugano kugula.
I turned the key. I could open the door.
Esimunevugano kugula.
I said, what's wrong with
this?
The voice of the Lord said,
there was a ngamba.
Take off your clothes. They have lost the anointing. I said, okay. He said, no miracle will happen today. No cripple will see. Cripple will walk. No blind will see. Voice spoke over the wind, over the door. So I took off the clothes quickly. I dressed. I never even struggled with the door. I opened the door. The door opened. I said, who was behind the door? It was my destiny. My destiny was saying, you've now been brought to this level. You can't play the same games of yesterday.
My God.
So I took it off, dressed properly. What happened? And the driver whom they were sent, he said to me,
Nangamba,
my goodness,
Banange.
You are dressed and smart like your spiritual father.
Oyamba denga chitao womo.
Now,
Katulia.
Dr. T.L. Osborne,
Dr. T.L.
was a pastor of John Austin.
Yasumbanga John Austin.
He was his spiritual father.
Yalichitao.
So he had honor and respect. Now the clothes I was wearing from the same shop gave me dignity to be treated not like a preacher from Africa, but at the same level as my spiritual father. Oh, you are not hearing what I'm talking about. My God, if there is any demon we're going to break today, we are breaking that spirit of familiarity, of similitude. We are breaking that spirit. That manipulative, that controlling spirit. Now listen to this.
What is that?
Sit down. So they opened the door. I entered. We drove. We reached. I entered in John Austin's office. It was still at Lakewood Church.
Lakewood
Church was still in a tinned house. Not the other one where John Austin took it to another level. But the first one, then they had the first one, the second one, and now what they have. And John Austin was young. John Austin called everybody.
John Austin,
he said, come and see my brother from Africa. He called all his elders. He said, we are expecting miracles. He said, Papa Osborne told me, the same anointing on him is on you. The same anointing on Idahosa is on you. You are his two wonderful lions of Africa. I said, yes. But inside of me, I said, I have issues. But the outside, the spirit was broken. So he introduced me. This is what he said. He said, you know me, church.
Anybody who comes with broken toes, toes outside, dirty suits, I'll never bring him here in the pulpit. I don't care whether he was sent by the poor. Because that spirit of poverty, I don't want it to come upon you. But I'm introducing you the Prince of Heaven, a Son of God. Look at him now. And I preached. And when I finished preaching, he said, we're going to help this young man with $5,000. And we're going to help his ministry every month. He said, every month our pulpit is open. If you ever want to come, the miracles we have seen. I went home. I cried. The clothes I had gone with from Uganda, I grabbed them. I put them in the dustbin. And I said, you demon, never follow me the rest of my life. That spirit, when it's on you, it becomes manipulative. And Satan will send you as his agent. But we are not poor. We are rich. That's why I made a decision. Even the former pastors used to work here, they will tell you, I will never carry used clothes for a pastor. Never. I say, you know what? If I'm going to give them something, I'll give them something new. Let me tell you what the manipulative spirit does. It causes you to cry where you shouldn't cry. You
see an elderly man?
You remember the people who were eating embeba? Was it in Soroti? Bali Rudawa? You remember Bali Rudawa? You were a mess. Somewhere.
The people are dying of hunger. So we are eating rats. And
it
eats a rat.
TV.
On television.
You are manipulating who? No, you are not going to manipulate anybody.
Those demons have a network.
They will never be happy.
And people who are
because they are thinking that someone else is having their blessings. Someone else has... No, God is my source. I'm not looking at anybody. And my God shall supply.
Break that spirit.
Spirit
on you.
Spirit
it moves on people. If you ain't got nothing to wear,
eh?
You ain't have clothes. If you don't have clothes, good clothes. At least you go in. Go like Lazarus. The world will help you.
But
you live a decent clothes. Nice shoes. Nice shirts.
No, get a sister who
go to where your sister
your manager.
And she's the manager. She's the boss. And you embarrass her.
Over brother who work
with where your brother works from.
No, me embarrassing.
And you embarrass them before their colleagues.
That is demonic. That is demonic.
You see the people who come here.
Eh?
When we are giving,
olinajira okwompola
and someone sneaks through
oba bamusabire
to pray for them
nina pastor kinjagala omugamba
I want to say something to pastor
nebamuga nti ogira olindako
hold on
nalwagana n'abantu
and they begin to strike with the
okaba it's the same spirit kakati fa abagimanyi
I just ignore you.
Spirit is manipulative.
It's a manipulative spirit.
It
makes people do things you don't expect them to do. Someone can throw themselves in the road.
President
when the president is passing by.
They
even open the breasts, demonstrating with breasts which are open.
Whom are you scaring? You
had no bra when you were created.
In Genesis, women never had bra.
So, open your breasts, who cares?
Stop the witchcraft. Manipulative spirit. It takes away decency.
Ne kukujja kem pieces on bantu.
Banyigiriza nyo. Banyigiriza nyo kane yambule.
Let me undress before the whole world.
Mama huyu akuzala tolina ngoyo.
Your mama gave birth to you naked. It's nothing new.
Tolina chotutisa.
Nothing new.
Tujja kwewunya bwewunya kubanga enkanyanyi zikujjudde kakati.
We shall be shocked at what we see.
Apart from that, totutisa tis.
You're not intimidating nobody.
We thought you're looking at
you are so mad.
Yeah, I know. Let me tell you, God is not in a crisis. The kingdom of God is not in a crisis.
Kan tali mukatiyabaga.
Olaba muzungu noja yengo yenkadde.
When a white person shows up, you dress miserable.
No,
when a black man shows up, you mistreat them.
Gamba kulina nye tonti satisa.
Tell the person next to you, don't intimidate me.
Even though
you look miserable,
those
are devils, you're casting them out.
Hallelujah. Somebody clap your hands. God is good. You know what?
What again?
I just looked at you. What do you do? Mwala sente.
She's a money lender.
Yeah, business yokola.
That's your business.
Nga family.
It's a family business.
Look at how she's dressed. That's the way.
What?
You can actually do business.
Umuntu osolokola na business. Umuntu ayambadde what?
Yeah.
Yeah. She says, I used to be a Muslim. You can see the glory of God on her. That God has done something in her life. Stop dressing miserable. You're not impressing nobody. Don't.
Let's do what we can. The Lord
will bless it.
Take the hair from the
salon. Ever since Mama took off those clothes, you can't know she was a Muslim. Come, Mama. Come, Mama. She goes to
every
salon
every day.
Every day.
you can see the difference that Jesus is in her life.
Yesu ya chala. Yesu ya jia. Look at her.
Immediately now, ma'am.
Stand here, ma'am.
And say, kwetegereze.
May the world see you.
Atadeka kumbura go kami ansa we katoweza no ganta right the room beach. Now, if you apart from the sigida jari na mchenge,
gojeko sigida.
Neka tibo mtu nolida.
When you look at her,
nagamba Yesu alokola awonya.
Jesus heals and saves. You believe.
Mokama tugomemo omo yoyo wolu manyira manyiro.
May God drive that familiar spirit out of us.
Julianga rubira ango spirit yeyo tosona jinyo telinana linya.
It has no name.
It's the spirit of the locust.
Moyo wan
yetuka wantu neri abuli chintu chona ne chimala wone ebuka ne genda wala ne kalizo yo ne mumali ye gimuzimu gwendwa de.
It's a sickness.
Gumana kukaliza ne gugende wagundi ne ufa ne gugende wagundi. Goes to jigoba muli nya lya Yesu.
We drive it out.
Fire!
Fire!
So my sister, when that spirit come, bagambe bugambe. Atita, omanyi spirit yeye chakola.
You know what it does?
Let me tell you something. What it does? It causes you to confess that you have no money, because if you say you have money, they will ask for it. So they say, please give me. And the devil wants you to say, I have no money. And yet the Bible says, let the poor say, I am rich. So in other words, you don't say, I have no money. Gambe, baba deba kazituwala.
They've just taken the money.
Okay, yeah.
You've come late.
Oh, what is in that talk?
Oh, it's on its way.
Is it Jadivanange?
When is it coming?
Simanyinange, na izija.
I know it's coming.
So that you do not confess yourself in poverty. You don't confess yourself in sickness.
Don't put their curse on yourself. Let them continue in their curse if they want.
Are you with me? Amen.
Amen.
Mama Tula.
Onyumie. You are really smart.
Mama wange ya gamba.
My mama used to say.
Bo yaraba ngo mchara nga yamba debwato na tereza.
When she would dress.
Omanyi osoro kubundula oba no tereza. Mama wange gamba. Ha. Moka agundi asibye kabada. Chantu alile banga deno kutegera what she meant.
It took a long time to understand what she meant.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you praise.
We tend to come on.
Money will come to you.
Thank you, Lord.
Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Him.
Praise God, church.
Amen.
Can we give hands to the Holy Spirit? Pastor, I didn't know about the Holy Spirit. I've been born again for the last about 8 years. But I was so green about it, because I just used to hear Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit. I used to ask myself, what is it all about? Is it a dove? Is it what? I didn't know. But through the last Friday, actually I was just welcoming the Holy Spirit, as you say. And then all of a sudden, I saw a blackout. I just went into, can I call it coma? I don't know how I went down. I found myself down. I was out of myself. And I said, God, from today onwards, my life has changed. I've been going through this challenge of financial breakthrough. So from that time, I just knew I've moved to another level. Pastor, kindly allow me to call my wife and kids, because I know when they step here, the whole family is going to change. My sweetheart, Duty Grace, please come. Come with the kids. And Pastor, as I was stepping here, I felt something under my feet. I wasn't settling. I was just feeling, I'm like, God, you've answered my prayer. Pastor, I have a company. I do events. I remember I used to work in a fish factory. The fish factory made me hate employment. So she's here, my lovely wife. So,
come on, why are you tying those things on people?
Twala, twala.
amaba wiki gwei chabu twale ichigoyi olira chenjogera take it
So I remember you had a crusade in Chirombe where I live. I never used to live by there by that time. So I was dating this beautiful lady and I didn't have money. Then I remember through your preaching you said, let's go buy without money. She used to ask me, when is our wedding? When is our wedding? Then I used to ask myself, and then I was going also through family challenges, you know, forces from all different directions. Then I remember we just sat down with her and chose a date. And when we chose that date, we just started working towards it. We called meetings, because I remember my family could sit me down, ask me, how much do you have in your account? How much money do you have? I had nothing, but I could tell them I have some good money. So, long story short, our wedding was very successful. Glory be to Jesus. Another thing, Pastor, as a family, I thank God, first of all, I was going through this very, very hard, through this hurdle. I remember sometime back in Salvation, I sold a car. I had a VW, a Volkswagen Combi, a transporter minibus. It used to help me do my business. But then I sold it and... you know, I didn't get the reward, and somehow, you know, somehow I said these issues of sowing cars, maybe it's not a good thing, and you know, I was so broken down. Then, but through the 77 days, I picked up the courage and said, no, God, I need to move to another level, because I wanted my business to grow. I wanted to develop as a young man, and I hate this issue of depending on people. Please help me, help me. No, I said, no, I should be independent. So what I did, the Spirit spoke to me, and then my prayer was, I wish the same Spirit can speak to my wife so that we are in the same spirit. Because when you get married, you cannot make a decision on your own. So I have this small car at home. I had this small car at home called a Corsa, Toyota Corsa. I don't know whether the picture can be showed on the screen. I don't know if they have it. But I have that car. So I wanted to sell that car all along, but I was battling within me. Should I give it? Should I? Shouldn't I? Then I opted to sell it off. Then I looked for a buyer. Honestly speaking, when God has spoken, you can't arm twist God, church. Let me assure you. I looked for buyers and failed. Finally, we agreed. When I went home and told my wife about it, she said, it's okay if it's about sowing it, it's okay. I tried to ask the kids said, yes, daddy, we shall get another car. We shall even get a better one. You know? So I realized we are in the same spirit. So today, I'm handing over my car to this gentleman here. Yes. He has been a challenge to me. Guy amazes me. He's always alert. You know, serving besides you is not an easy thing. You're somebody who is very fast, you're very quick, and you want people who are sharp. This guy is very sharp. I salute you.
Amen.
Pastor, I loved this car so much because it was my first time owning a Japanese car. It takes very little fuel, easy to maintain. You know, it would fit my family. You know, if just 10K, you can go a distance. He's called Fabrice.
Hey, how are you, buddy? How are you, man?
Okay. He was even telling us along the way that he wants to see Pastor Kayanja.
Okay, how are you? Are you going to come on the 24th?
at 10. Will you come at 10? On the 24th.
Yes.
Come here at 10 with your brother, okay? Okay? Come at 10 on the 24th. I have a surprise for you. Okay. Father, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. I bless your holy name. May the Lord increase you. May he seize your faith. Someone is watching. The angels are watching. God is watching. He will prosper you. And he will answer all your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Amen.
Yes.
Praise God, church. Praise God. I want to thank Pastor Jessica Kayanja and Pastor Robert Kayanja. Okay. And I thank Pastor Jessica Kayanja for teaching us women how to pray for our husbands. Because my husband had a vagabond spirit whereby I could tell him we have to sell that car, and he insists that no, we have to retain that car at home. So he could take the car to those brokers who tried to sell the car. He could go to the brokers, and the brokers start talking to him. Gabamunyumiza raga. Banyumia! Akomo waka nebamugamba, we shall give you 2 million. So I told him, you're not selling a laptop. Until we got the logbook of the car, the day there was a woman who was giving testimony here. And we believed God that we are going to get that logbook because we thought we are going to sell it. So we got the logbook, we put it on top of the TV. We were going to pray. There was a woman who was giving a testimony that her demons have come to see what you're doing. So we were like, we're also going to pray. When we started praying like this, the TV exploded. It went off. So after 2 days, my young son started praying. He said, no, I have to watch Pastor Kayanja. Pastor Kayanja is my friend. I can't be there without watching TV.
Oh.
Then we said, we believe God. We shall get money and we shall buy another TV. So he was there, he used to sing because he loves Hadija so much. He started singing like Hadija. Then I told him, you don't mind, God will do us a miracle. He will do us great things. Since that day I was having headache because they told me I'm 3.5 months pregnant. So I was sitting there, I was supposed to come up here with him when he stepped, but I was feeling dizzy until when he called me and I felt a bit dizzy. I don't know what happened. Then I told my children, we have to trust God. We pray God will bring us a better TV. So every day he tells me, Mommy, you should bring a big TV like that one for Pastor Kayanja, so that I see Pastor Kayanja. In the morning when he woke up, he switched on the TV. The TV was bringing the sound, but there's no photo. So I said, this is a miracle. So they keep on watching TV. I mean, they listen to the TV like a radio, but there's no photo. I told them, you stay there until God will do us a miracle and we shall buy a new TV.
Oh. My friend, you want a TV like this one? You like that one? You like that one or this one? Look at that one. You like that one? Huh? Come on, buddy. Let's talk TV. Come here, let's talk TV. Come on, come. Okay, let's talk TV. We are on TV now. You want to say hi to the people? Say hi. Okay, you don't want to be on TV? Say hello. What is your name? What do they call you?
Say your name.
What is your name?
What's your name?
Yes. You scared him. Okay. So, we're going to get you a good TV.
We're going to find your TV at a notch.
Yeah. We're going to get him a flat screen. A flat screen like that one.
We're going to put a flat screen there.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
A good one.
A nunch.
What size is this?
You know, sizes.
Someone gave this one, others I'll give it you this one. He gave this one, he said, I want it to be here so that it can work as a monitor.
Yeah, monitor.
How much is this one? 48 inches. Huh? So LGs are good. Huh? The good ones are what? LG or Sony? Or LG? How much are they? 3 million. Okay, get it. We'll get it tomorrow, so that my friend can watch.
Amen,
Pastor.
Yeah.
May God bless you, Pastor.
So that he can watch a TV. You are on TV.
Bakulaba.
Wave your hand to the people and say hi. You see, whatever you do, the TV does. You know that? Whatever you do, the TV does. Okay, Amma, put the camera on this one. Close. Uh-huh. Now wave. You see? Whatever you do, the you in TV waves. If you keep quiet, he keeps quiet. If you smile, he smiles. Wave like this. Say amen. You see? Say amen.
Amen.
You see, my friend? Whatever he does, the TV does. You are quiet, the TV is quiet. Kids are amazing to see. It's just, come on, clap your hands to Jesus and give a praise to the Lord. Yes. Let's go quickly, please.
Pastor, just briefly, I wanted to partner with your ministry. I'm a florist. Actually, my best man for my wedding day, my best man is the one who makes for you flowers, Dennis, and he's my friend. So I wanted to partner with him so that I help him with whatever he does in this church.
Wonderful. Yes, you'll contact him since you know him.
Thank you.
Amen. And tomorrow he has a lot of work to do. Yes. Actually, today. Yes.
Abaluganda Yesu yebazibwe.
Tukendeze ko banange. Nchali na line eri. Ne line eri. So, buli ali wano. Kendezako.
Pastor, ewaffe mukikatwali. Twenyigira nyo byokusamira.
We were so much in witchcraft in our clan.
Mukama ananyamba nendokoka
nansa. God helped me and saved me.
Nebo yandokola. Nengenda waka nengwata akabiri nenjo chama sabogonna.
So I destroyed all the shrines at home.
Abeka ne bageza ako nyo kunumba naye kuba nali mu kama saina cha kizibu chona cha ntuko.
Nothing happened to me.
Naye bwaga manti twina jushi dina.
When you said we have a Jewish dinner. Kubanga
eje bikolo je chika twasalanga embuzi tusalente tusale mwendiga. Ne bwaga manti twina jushi dina wali.
You said you're going to have a Jewish dinner.
The
Holy Ghost told me to participate in it.
We used to
sacrifice animals in the world.
When I
got some money
yesterday, I bought
7 sheep.
You said
you have to kill 77 sheep.
I said, 7
are mine.
I brought
the sheep.
Zigambe zogere.
I'm
telling my sheep to speak on my behalf.
I request before. Tanzania.
I work in TZ.
When I came and found
this meeting, I
participated. I'm not missing anything.
I come every
day.
I have my prayer requests. I get paralyzed in my legs. There's always pain. The doctor said,
"I'm going to have diabetes."
The doctor said, "I'm going
to
have diabetes."
Secondly,
I have a school.
It is called Moza Kushanai School.
But we are lacking students. It has been like for over 5 years. But it is not expanding. Secondly, I had a vision that still I need Moza Christian University in the same place.
Pastor, you have 7 sheep.
She told me what to do. Before they cut them, I'm going to be on my sheep. There are
30.
I'm going to speak to them to speak. Say this. Say thus and that.
Madam, you are
going to tell
them.
30 sheep.
I'm going to 7 miracles this week.
For 7 miracles. Now 30 miracles. 30 miracles. And one miracle. That ship is going to speak.
They are going to speak. The revelation in Jifunya.
That's the revelation I got. May the Lord bless you.
My goodness. You watch, my brother. May God bless you.
Come on,
in Jesus' name.
This
is the tongue of his head.
Watch
it. You will testify.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Those are my names. I'm not the musician. I'm the princess of Jesus.
Pastor,
I don't know where to begin from, Pastor.
Glory belongs to Jesus. Pastor, on the 31st, I came here with my husband, with my family, 2 boys, with this picture. Behind that picture, I wrote, as you said, that before 21 days, and on the 17th, somebody is going to receive her miracle. And that's me. You know
what I got?
There is a lady on that photo. And that's my real mom.
Oh, your mama
Nzala. Oh, your mama wanga Nzala.
That's my mama.
Madam munonyo kumale banga.
I've been looking for her for a while.
Banange ratachi mbufunye.
I found her.
Wali?
She's here.
Wali wando.
She's here right now.
Pastor. 17th prayer request.
In the 17th prayer request.
Yeah, but number 11.
She was number 11.
But no, she's number first.
Kakati Yasose.
Yasose.
She's the first miracle. She's sitting here.
Mama Jango.
Mama. How long have you been waiting? 2 years I've been looking for my mom. Help me bring my mom.
Munyambe. Mangala.
Why me?
My dad is
a Muslim. I have my mother on my side.
Those are the names
of my
father.
He's a real witch.
But he brought
my
mother.
She loved you when I was still young.
When you went to Nambole, she was there. She told me, will I go to Pastor Kayanja's
place
and tell him how much you love her? Problems came. Water used to come into the house where she was living. We couldn't live in the house. I got pregnant. The water will fill the house and everything will be swept out. When the house fell,
could
I take up the village? She woke up and left the home and went to the
street.
She refused to go back home.
77 days.
But 77 days of glory. She's one of my prayer requests. I've been praying daily.
Then I go back home and again I pray.
From church and from home.
The whole day, the whole night we can pray for her.
I want to build my own house. So my mom is fast. I don't know how to feel.
I found her.
I'm going to take care of the kids.
I'm going to look for mom.
So ona yali mama one
and she's there now.
That's the mother.
She's here.
Uliriza kubuza ebibuzo.
So condemn chiba kubuziza.
Mama wo yono mu kifananyi.
Is that your mother?
Yo.
Wanonga yali nani?
Who is that?
Yo, your brother we.
That's her brother.
Omukuru kwada.
Her elder brother.
Kakati
what was she doing on Queensway? She was selling Irish potatoes. She has no home. Let's go slow.
2 years. Yali muradde wa mutwe yali akoze ekiki.
And the pastor Macharo nategeya naye. Maybe yeye awulire nako kumuteka mu muzigo atenga yali landlady na ye nga mu butufu nafe tuna chakola by then tetwali na sente tuzimbe nyombe yambagirawo.
Okay, kati webaza Katonda mama wa mulabye olwanyalo emyaka ebiri.
Yes,
good. Kale take mikono gyaffe waggulu twebaze Mukama.
Lift your hand and
webale Yesu. Webale Mukama. The union of the sister, I mean a daughter and the mother. We pray that you are God of miracles. And you do signs and wonders. In Jesus' name. Amen. Yes.
Praise God, church. Praise God, Mommy Jessica and Pastor Robert Kayanja.
I'm so happy to be here. This is my husband.
Mzee waje kauku ewa Pastor Abbe Coyne zinga 77 zakatandika.
We came to Kauku.
No, to Buria 77 dogs.
Told us about 77 days of glory.
By that time, twali tutekateke mikolo na yenga wo manyi byemikolo ngoli muweleza.
We were preparing for the wedding.
Nene ngamba mzee agambye mgenda kubera mwe byamagere bitakirisika.
He said God has.
So I got a seat.
Nemfuna nsiku.
Nezija wa mami Jessica na tusabira.
And I gave it to Pastor Chance to pray.
Very successful.
Wedding was successful.
tuwezezo mwezi gumune naku mkaga.
We are 1 month old and 6 days.
Iwa netende tuchidiza mkama.
We give God the glory.
Echoku ineneba za mkama. Yali service ranga ya kaongezi. Mzei notu gamba abasumba. Tualiwa abawirako. Notu gamba nti moya gala mkama teko buweleza abu international level.
You wanted us to take our ministry to another level?
Waluwe chali chetagisa kuchano cho 44.
Something was needed.
Notu gamba tusigolu kumirwa dola.
You told us to sow $1,000. I had 360,000. I'd never given $1,000.
But inside in me, Naulidanga is supposed to do that.
Naulidanga no chikola.
Was it tomorrow? Longa to zile tankera.
We were supposed to bring the next day.
When that dayo ne ne ora sent, nengi ne womo tunapara sent.
I got money. I borrowed money from somebody.
Nenzi changinga mulukumirwa dola.
And turned it into a exchange.
Nenzi sabira nenga mukama njaga lotu wetaka. Kwa tsola kusabuwe za international level. Ngatobu wa detaka.
I said, give us land, Lord.
Tuali tupangisa kafukati.
We used to rent a small
the
place. The church was wooden. I believe God for land. God gave us land worth 120 million. On Entebbe Road in Baita, Ababidi Town. I'm always here. God, we thank you for the land.
But
these shelters are embarrassing. God gave me a car as well.
$1,000
gave me a car as well. As I'm going to sell this car,
or to Zimbabwe church, at least never see a permanent,
you may
see a cathedral,
a
at least a
good church.
But
God has built us a building of worth.
We're
just waiting to roof it.
We
shall be glad when Pastor comes.
77 is the that and
when these meetings began, you want to come, but I was watching on TV. Last week, but one.
Pastor Eddie now Julie's always busy.
Testified about that pregnant.
Nina Mwala Wango, no?
I have my daughter.
Michala Mufumbo, na yeye akulia bachala Mwita Mwala ni mchaji. Ayagala nyo okulundo kuva linatandika omusumba.
She's been taken care of.
Nalundo obuzi, nalundo obuzi. Nakola nenga bigana. Kati Pastor Eddie wali awo obujulizi
bwe. Pastor Eddie was testifying about this. Nenga mbamu,
nenga kwata kutulinga mu. Kama chomchira labogere na yachifune. Banaye nayo ndoza byarwal katonda ina amani.
God is amazing.
Mweyo yenyini wiki.
That very week.
Omuntu najja kuduka aliye.
Someone came to our shop.
Na mubuzo ayagala okulunda.
Do you want to graze?
Na mugama kuwadde mbizi 10 zo nanga zili gwako.
10 pigs that are all pregnant.
Mbizi 10 mzee.
10 pigs.
Zina enzungu eva olupaka walingulumu zwe.
Long pigs.
Bwebeza dabana batyezala abana 10.
It gives back a birth to about 10 kids.
Mbizi 10 zigera kuzala vanyimalo 2 miezi ebili ndo zabe bana 10.
That will be 100 pigs.
Na atakoma kwecho.
Stop there.
Na mbuzo genda zirundira wa.
Na mgambe
wakana mkai huo wafunda zina mbizi za lulio.
These ones are.
Nonye taka.
Look for land.
Bana yabinyimiza nganange sikiriza.
I cannot believe it.
Katonda akole ebya magere.
God does miracles.
Zeyi we bale gondera mukama.
Thank you Pastor Benga.
Omwami
took them to their land, gave them 10 acres. When you are taking care of
sheep,
they need food.
They need
to grow so many things.
Glory be to God.
Give them 10 acres.
They're
going to build houses.
Embizi 10 ngabuli mbizi ya mitwala 55.
Every
million 5.
Banayi
wabasika tondo yani.
That's God.
Kuwira Yesu ngaleza ma.
Clap your hands to Jesus.
Mzee nalangira mataka.
Pastor declared
that. Katolus pemba sizze wanbera ku TV.
I'm watching on TV.
Nange nenzayo nengambe ndigaza ngezi chalye nyinji.
I told my sheep.
Banayi tukirize mukama akole ebya magere.
Let's believe God for miracles.
Nemba gamba tugera funa mataka.
I said we're going to get land.
Obokirize taka duko nkwate ko. By faith just.
One young man placed
it.
He touched
me.
The next day the dad gave him land. If I don't come, I'm watching.
Yesterday service.
Yesterday during the service. I was preaching.
Actually, service.
It was a testimony service. The Holy Ghost told us to give our equipment.
You know,
I know how God speaks. I said, where? I was thinking as a human.
Who
were there?
Praise.
There is a gentleman, a police officer, who is a...
Yes.
We have sown our CD, 77 CD. We are believing God.
We have a fellowship.
We don't have sound equipment.
Those
are the people supposed to have the equipment. I went back. I told the church people to prepare. We didn't have sound. We brought the sound. Afande, your equipment is here. Fande, come with your team.
Police fellowship,
the police fellowship has equipment now.